Here in Florence, we are getting acquainted with a lot of stakeholders, so more than 140 registered people that we can help them to understand how the system that is changing, is rapidly changing, and so what kind of transformation and how this transformation can be mastered in order to get the best.
We, Vito Energy Bill, as participants to the European project SmartNet, built the coordination schemes between TSOs and DSOs. Now, after the results of the pilots, we are planning to use our outcome to create recommendations for the implementation of these schemes so that they can bring benefits to the people.
Work Package 2 provides a simplified model of a distribution network suited for an ancillary service market with the required clearing time. This work package provides models for aggregation of ancillary services provided by various distributed energy resources. Work Package 2 develops market clearing mathematical models for different TSO-DSO coordination schemes. What this work package has shown is that although it is the most challenging, the way forward is a common TSO-DSO market, which enables the most economically efficient provision of ancillary services.
So in terms of market and aggregation, so SmartNet focused on the real-time activation of energy, but important future direction will be to also investigate reserve sizing and also reserve procurement for these ancillary services. Another aspect is to investigate further the market power exercised by some market participants and also to find countermeasures for the DSOs and TSO to counteract this fact. In terms of market and aggregation, SmartNet focused on the real-time activation of these ancillary services. Future direction will need to investigate the sizing of reserves together for the DSO and TSO, but also the procurement of these reserves. Another important aspect is to study market power that can be exercised by commercial market parties. And so we'll need also to investigate countermeasures to be applied by the DSO and the TSOs.
So we have just concluded our research on ICT requirements in different TSO-DSO coordination schemes proposed by SmartGrid project. The final findings are that ICT systems can be fit to the identified requirements, but further research is needed on security and on communication quality, especially at the edge of the grid. So the next step is to finalize the ICT part of the cost-benefit analysis and put the findings into practice. All of the findings can be now downloaded from the SmartNet webpage.
So SmartNet is the only project dealing with a large-scale simulator able of simulating both transmission, distribution, and all the devices that are participating to ancillary services market. This will be very important from any kind of stakeholder point of view, since it's providing very detailed results at surgical level and is capable of drawing very precisely the recommendation for technical, economical, and regulatory point of view.
We were able to meet the main objective of the pilots, which was to demonstrate that the technological solutions proposed within the project can be brought into real life. Of course, when doing so, we faced a number of issues and challenges, but we were able to solve them. So now we have a number of lessons learned, which can be very useful for anyone who wants to bring those concepts into further pilots also. Now, the next steps will be to continue the execution of the pilots so that we can have more data and about what is happening there. We will also want to have them until running within winter and the beginning of spring, which is very useful in particular for the Italian case, in which we have a lot of run-of-river hydropower plants. And then afterwards, we also want to have the national workshops for Italy and for Spain. We already have it for Denmark. With this, we will get a very useful feedback, which will be afterwards put into the final reports, which will be available for everyone to be consulted in the SmartNet website.
So the aim of the regulatory analysis within the SmartNet project is to actually provide the stakeholders, regulators, industry, everybody who is interested in implementing the SmartNet, to provide them with the knowledge that we have obtained during the development of this work, in particular during the design of the markets and the pilot project's cost-benefit analysis, so that they can really learn and further implement and help them implement the DER into the system. In addition, we are going to compare the work that we have done with the legislation and the other national documents or stakeholder positions to tell them where the SmartNet project stands and how that can help them further. The next step is to provide regulators, industry and other stakeholders with a set of recommendations and, for example, to tell them what are the barriers or what are the possible solutions to implement some of the solutions from the SmartNet, and also to help with the further integration of distributed energy resources.
Results of our project could be very important for regulators, because you have to take into account that the future will be in getting ancillary services from distribution, and for sure there will be a regulatory framework to be set up. And our project is investigated which kind of TSO-DSO interaction and which kind of market analysis and setup could be the most favorable ones in order to favorize a good integration of those services. But of course, also the pilots have not to be forgotten, and those pilots could provide to the system some examples that, duly upscaled, of course, could be used in order to provide really applicational cases for this kind of TSO-DSO interaction and provision of services.